after the fathers made their great speeches, I'm not the best of speeches, so I'm going to read mine. I've been pining my mind over it for a long time, being friends with Ed so long. So I just want to say that I want to be up here to say a few words in honor of Ed and Beatrice. I've known them for a long time, and I want to honor them rather than roast them. Anyway, I just want to say Ed and Beatrice are incredibly lucky to have found each other and fallen in love, and that I really want to thank you for letting me participate in this night in honor of both of you. Love you both for it, you know. So what I'm going to do is, I've known you for almost 18 years, Ed. You're intelligent, athletic, charismatic, witty. those are my Nerf picks.
Organized.
Actually, it's a real honor being your best man, Ed, because you really are the best man I know. I just want to let you know that. And you're a really quality individual, and you're a lifelong confidant. I want to call it. And with that, I also want to, through the years, we're almost like brothers together, going through everything together. And I believe from age 16 to 18, my mother actually took him as a deduction on her tax return because she actually had to make up money from feeding him all those years. So she couldn't be here, I had to bring that to your attention. Beatrice, you really look stunning today. I just want to say that. And to the bridesmaids, you just look absolutely gorgeous today. And your beauty does not compare to your soul, and it's a very good contribution to Ed's life and the rest of his family. So, very nice. So anyway, I just want to say the best and beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touched, but felt by the heart. So anybody can stand with me and toast to the new Mr. and Mrs. Tsai. May your hearts be full of happiness.
Cheers.